Bobby and Cheryl's remarkable love story spans four decades, marked by the absence of conventional romantic elements. While their marriage appeared to be perfect on the surface, a hidden secret from Bobby's past, unknown to Cheryl, would soon emerge to disrupt their seemingly flawless union. What's even more astonishing is the unexpected source of this revelation. In January 2015, Cheryl Love's ordinary morning routine took an unexpected turn. She and her husband, Bobby, had peacefully cohabited for years when an abrupt knock on the door shattered their tranquility. Cheryl opened the door cautiously to find police officers on the other side, initially assuming it was another mix-up due to their neighbor's erratic behavior. However, what unfolded would change her life forever. A dozen officers with FBI on their jackets barged into her home. Hello, wonderful people. Welcome back to Story Scape, where we're about to embark on a heartwarming journey. Please make sure to hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell to stay updated on more incredible videos. Cheryl was bewildered but followed the officers as they headed straight to Bobby's bedroom. She overheard them inquire about Bobby's name and whisper something in response. To her shock, they handcuffed Bobby and led him out the door. Desperate for answers, Cheryl pleaded for clarity. Bobby somberly responded, "This goes way back, Cheryl, before I met you." With that, he was taken away. Bobby's past traces back to his childhood in North Carolina during the 1960s. Born as Walter Miller into a financially struggling family of eight, his life turned dark after being arrested for disorderly conduct following a Sam Cooke concert. This arrest set a series of petty crimes in motion, gradually escalating in severity. Walter admitted, "I got into all sorts of trouble, including petty theft, stealing from unlocked cars, and robbing government checks from mailboxes." As his criminal activities grew bolder, he eventually resorted to theft from a school band room. When he was apprehended for stealing, Walter's luck ran out, leading to his incarceration in a nearby juvenile detention center. Life in the detention center was a harsh transition for him. He despised everything about the place, from the food to the pervasive violence. He bore scars from numerous physical altercations with fellow detainees. Despite the difficulties, he plotted his escape while listening to the distant sounds of passing trains at night, longing for freedom. The opportunity for escape arrived one night when the guard by the detention center's door momentarily turned away. Walter bolted through the back door towards the train sounds, marking his first escape. He followed the railroad tracks from North Carolina to Washington, D.C., where he enrolled in high school, attended classes, and even participated in basketball with newfound friends. However, he soon fell into the company of individuals engaged in more serious criminal activities, including bank robbery. Walter joined his friends in a string of heists, feeling invincible after each score. Their criminal endeavors eventually crumbled when they targeted a bank with a silent alarm. As Walter left the bank, the police were already on the scene. He attempted to evade capture but was shot by an officer, marking the end of his criminal spree. Walter faced charges related to the bank robbery and another, receiving a 25 to 30 year sentence. During his incarceration, he decided to transform his life. While in prison, Walter became the model inmate, earning a transfer from maximum security to a more lenient minimum security facility. Though still heavily guarded, this new environment felt like a taste of freedom. Walter hosted his radio show and had no intentions of escaping. However, a series of negative reports changed his fate. A dispute involving another prisoner led to Walter being targeted by the prison captain, who issued infractions regularly. "The negative reports piled up, and I was one mark away from being sent back up the hill," Walter recalled. Fearing a return to maximum security, he began plotting his escape. Despite the harsh task of cleaning roads with a group of inmates as part of his punishment, Walter observed patterns and found an opportunity. During Tuesday morning shifts, the lax guard allowed inmates to board the bus without a pat-down. Walter also noted a consistent stop on the bus route near a wooded area. One Monday night, during a football game, he made the life-altering decision to escape. The next Tuesday, he seized his opportunity during a bus stop. As the bus slowed down, Walter swung open the back door and disappeared into the forest. He discarded his prison attire and, with the sirens fading, calmly asked strangers for directions to the Greyhound station. Boarding a bus bound for New York City, Walter sat quietly, starting a new chapter in his life. Arriving in New York City in November 1977, Walter adopted the new identity of Bobby Love and began rebuilding his life. Initially, he stayed in a motel, but dwindling funds left him homeless. Nonetheless, even from the streets, Bobby worked toward reconstructing his life. Through deception and fortunate circumstances, he acquired a social security number, a birth certificate, and eventually a driver's license. With these documents, he sought employment, worked odd jobs, and managed to cash paychecks while residing in inexpensive hotels. In the 1980s, Bobby secured a job in the Baptist Medical Center cafeteria in Brooklyn. There, he encountered a coworker who would later become his wife, Cheryl. Their first date consisted of watching Prince's Purple Rain and attending a Gladys Knight and the Pips concert. Cheryl stood out to Bobby, exuding innocence and gentleness, qualities that contrasted sharply with his tumultuous past. Bobby was drawn to her, and he aspired to build a life together. They married in 1985 when Bobby was 34 and Cheryl was 21. Their union brought four children into the world: Jasmine, Jessica, and later, twins Justin and Jordan. Despite juggling two jobs, surviving on only 2 hours of sleep each night, and facing the demands of raising a family, Bobby remained a dedicated father. He also became actively involved in his church, volunteered, and attended community meetings. On the surface, Bobby's life seemed perfect, but a dark secret from his past loomed large. Bobby yearned to reveal his past to Cheryl, but believed it was too risky. He knew Cheryl, a woman of unwavering righteousness, would likely urge him to turn himself in. He believed his previous life was far behind him, even though he maintained contact with some family members in North Carolina. He had instructed his sister to disclose his secret to Cheryl only after his passing. Still, she persisted, insisting that it was time to confess. Although he buried his past deep within him, Cheryl noticed subtle discrepancies in Bobby's behavior. He'd avoided being photographed, grew uneasy around strangers, and withdrew during arguments. The stress of maintaining his secret took a toll on him. Cheryl recalled a moment during Christmas of 2014 when she prayed in church, pleading for relief. The turning point came after a trip to North Carolina for a sibling's funeral. Bobby was recognized by someone who subsequently alerted the police. The FBI arrived at their New York home, and Cheryl witnessed Bobby being taken into custody. Her world was turned upside down. Cheryl's pain was overwhelming, but she knew she had to take action. Bobby was in a dire situation, detained at Rikers Island in New York while awaiting extradition to North Carolina. Cheryl visited him, witnessing the bleakness of his circumstances. During their first prison visit, Bobby broke down, convinced that Cheryl would leave him. Cheryl responded firmly, declaring her commitment to their marriage. Determined to secure Bobby's release, Cheryl employed every means. She wrote letters to the governor and even President Obama. She collected testimonials from Bobby's children and everyone else in his life. Cheryl presented her case with many character references before Bobby's parole board. Against all odds, after a year in prison, the parole board made the extraordinary decision to grant Bobby his freedom. He was allowed to resume the new life he had built, but it would never be the same. Cheryl forgave Bobby, and their marriage miraculously grew stronger after his secret was exposed. Bobby transformed, shedding the fear and anxiety that had haunted him for years. He became more open and engaged with people, particularly Cheryl. The couple felt a deeper connection than they had ever experienced before. Cheryl finally had the marriage she desired, free from the burden of Bobby's hidden past. On the day of his release, she confronted Bobby, asking, "Are we the Loves or are we the Millers?" His response was unequivocal: "We love, we love."